Hey, how you guys doing? This is William Myers, Manis Outdoors. Today we're going to be continuing in our trapping series, and we're going to be showing you another trap. This one is a little bit on the difficult side. I know I've told you guys I really don't like difficult traps. I don't like complicated traps. This isn't really that bad. But as far as the ones that I have been showing you, this one is a little bit more complicated. The reason why I like this is because I have an amazing amount of luck with this. It's almost like I'm building a primitive conibear or body grip trap for that matter. So stay tuned. We're going to show you guys the components to the trap, and then we're going to go step by step into building it. All right, guys, like I said, this trap may be just a tad on the difficult side, but it is a really, really good trap that gets really, really good results, in my opinion. I've had very, very good luck with this trap. But what you're going to need for this trap is basically four sticks. And I like to make my sticks almost to my armpit. See? Almost to my armpit. Just like that. And that's for all, well, these two at least. And then the other sticks that are that length have a Y in them, just like this. Okay? Now, credit for this trap has to go to a good friend of mine, Malik. I seen this trap, oh gosh, years ago. I can't even tell you when, probably 2009 maybe, I don't know. Not sure, maybe even before that. But he did it in a certain way, and I took that same method and changed it to work for my favor and work for me. And like I said, since then I've had tremendous luck with this trap. So, you know, like I said, the credit for my discovery of this trap, for that matter, goes to my friend Malik. So, other than the two Y sticks, we're going to put them up. What I like to do is get a pretty decent size, about that size, half inch to 3/4 inch in diameter stick, and that's the top of the trap. And then for the bottom, I want about half of that diameter. So about a half inch or so, a little bit more than a half inch. So that's the top and the bottom. Now, the next step for this and what you need for it is just a pretty decently sized, about half your pinky size green stick and your Leatherman awl. Got my daughter out here with me in the woods today, guys, so if you hear her, that's what that is. It's daddy-daughter day out in the woods. All right, so what I did was I grabbed my Y-sticks, and I kind of pre-measured and made sure that this stick was going to sit in there very good. Because basically, the long and the short of this trap is this is going to look like this when we're done. Just like that. Everything's going to be lashed together. Just like that. So I pre-measured, kind of looked, and made sure it was going to sit in there okay. And what I got to do is I got to shave this up a little bit, but that's not a big deal at all. But on the other side, it fits really, really, really well. So the reason why I did that is because I want to find out what the top and what the bottom of the trap is going to be. So this is going to be the bottom of the trap right here. I'm going to take my knife and I'm going to kind of hew this out a little bit. I'm going to kind of hew this out a little bit and make it a little bit flatter than what it is. And then I'm going to drill holes with my leather awl, and then I'm going to make sharpened spikes and I'm going to implant them into the bottom of this trap. So I'm going to get started on that. Don't go away.
Thank you.
Alright guys, so what I did was, I basically made this as flat as I could. It's got a little bit of a dip right here, but the bottom of my trap has a pretty much a natural dip in it as well. So it pretty much works out just right. This is going to slam together just like this, leaving as little as of a gap as possible. So next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill the holes into this, like I said, with my leather awl. So I'm going to start my holes pretty much right about here and then go in. They don't need to be any more than that. And I don't need any more than like four. This isn't like I'm wanting to spear whatever I catch in this trap, which is more likely a raccoon or a possum. But I'm not looking to completely spear and kill them. I'm just looking to hold them here with these spikes. Basically grip a hold of them and keep them in the trap. Some hard wood there. Okay, so there's one of my holes. Get a knife out here and kind of clean that up a little bit. All right, guys, so there's my first hole right there, and we're gonna go ahead and put the rest of the holes in here and we'll get right back with you. Alright guys, so we're back and we've got our four holes drilled, and what we want to do with that green stick is basically, like I said, we're gonna make sharpened points for this, and then we're just gonna implant them into the holes that we drilled into the stick here. And they don't have to be, you know, Loctited in with super glue or anything like that. They just need to be in there decently okay. Need to cut this one down a little bit. Okay. And we need to get our first spike going here. Should be good enough. Like I said, this is just to pin the animal between the two pieces of wood. Just basically hold him there, to help hold him there. That's plenty good enough. Right there, just like that. Let's see, we got three more to do. All right, guys, there you go. There's that top piece finished. All four spikes in there. It's about all I need because my Y stick kind of will go on this side, and we'll show you the promontory peg that we're going to put in here. We'll go pretty much in the middle here, and we'll get to that here in a minute as well. But like I said, this is just kind of to pin the animal up so that when he does get in this trap, that he can't wiggle his way out, which 9 times out of 10, I can use this trap without these and it will work. I just have a little bit greater success with these teeth in there. All right, so I'm gonna show you guys how to make a promontory peg, so don't go away. All right, guys, so just found a decent size around about a foot, less than a foot, stick. With my daughter playing over there on the tarp. You just want to get a good flat edge on both sides. That's not bad. You can see it kind of zigs and zags a little bit. It's not really that big of a deal. No big deal at all. So now what I want to do is cut it completely in half. I'm going to decide a good spot to do that at. I want it right about there. Alright, so that piece that we cut just now, I want to take a file real quick and I want to get that a little bit more level, because when I was sawing it, I had a little bit of a jump. Not that big of a deal, but it's better if you can get this as flat as possible. Alright, so I want this to go back together just like this. But what I want to do is basically take what I call the L7 out. I'm going to take a hunk out of this and a hunk out of that. And then I'll flip it and put it together just like that. And you'll see what I mean here in a second. It's not that big of a deal. I'm going to take this down about halfway into the wood. About like that. And then take my saw blade and flip it just like that, pop that out. And I don't know if exactly what's going to happen with this knot here, but we'll find out here in a second. No big deal. Nothing that this file won't help. Don't really need it on this side, but I might as well. Alright, that's our promontory peg, guys. And what I'm going to do is, the side that knot's on, I'm going to actually take it and I'm going to square it off. Almost to a point, but not a point. Just going to make it that much more sensitive. See, I can put weight on that promontory peg just like that. But when something comes here and brushes it, it's going to collapse. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and put together the rest of the trap. All right, guys, so let's get to lashing our trap together. And what I want to do is I want to try to get a decently flat surface here. And the reason why is because I'm going to have this other stick, the bottom side, this is going to be traveling. So, you know, I want something that's not going to really interfere with this very much. So what I like to do is kind of take my knife and give a little bit of a shave to this. You don't really have to, but as long as I'm showing you guys, might as well do it for you. And there you guys go, as simple as that. Let's take it down that other side there, just because that knot on that other side. That's about as much chopping as I would do with a knife like this. But now I want to lash this trap together. And what I'm going to do just start out right about there. Mark, just visually mark where I want to start my lash. I'm going to start out my lashings with a timber hitch. And all that means is that I'm going to start a loop in my bank line here. I'm going to put my finger in and twirl it around until it gets a little tight. Throw it around one side, come around and grab it with my two fingers, pull it through, and that's a simple timber hitch. That's not going to go nowhere. And I didn't really have to tie anything. Very, very simple hitch. All right, guys, so now what I'm gonna do is go three times around the other way, and then I'm gonna frap it, and that's gonna be that lash. So let's show you guys that. Starting our lash this way three times. I'm gonna keep that as tight as I can for right now, and then we're gonna give it a real good cinch here in a second. Two. Three. All right. Once around the bottom, just like this, that is just going to put us in the opposite direction of our lash, and we start three wraps on that side. One, keeping it as tight as possible. Two, three. What you guys see is behind me is that second tripod. I just purchased another camera for close-up shots and stuff. It's not running right now. We'll be here in a minute. All right, now what we're gonna do is frap. And what frapping means is going in between the spaces right here. But I wanna get that a real cinch. And now start going in between there. Once I get one time completely around, I'm gonna take, let me just take this stick here. Give it a good wrap, because this is what's going to marry all this up and have it real tight. Give that a good cinch. One more. Around. Cinch that up. And number three. All right, so I'm gonna stop right there. Pull my stick out. Now what I have is I'm holding the string right here. All right, guys, so this is what I'm left with, and I'm holding my thumb right there. All I need to do is I'm gonna go three times around and then put two looping half hitches in, which is gonna make a clove hitch. Oop, wrong way. There you go, that's a clove hitch. And we could cut and burn that, but might as well just loop a couple more times around and put another half hitch in there. All right, so let's burn this in right here. Sorry if I'm out of frame sometimes, guys. Just trying to get this tied in. Not the perfect shot every single second, but we'll do our best. Alright, guys, so that's our lash. Kind of not the neatest lash I've ever done, but we're just trying to get this done. But we're going to do the exact same thing over on the next side, and we'll get right back to you. All right, guys, so this is what we've made so far. And if you can imagine, this is going to get pounded into the ground pretty much just like this. So let's go down to the water's edge to where I have some raccoon runs and set this up. All right, guys, we're here at the water's edge right now. And what we got going on right now is a place that I favor for raccoon trapping. And this is one of my old dirt hole sets. And it goes quite a bit way back there. And actually, we've got a stick here. It goes quite a ways back here. About that far. And that's just enough for a raccoon. You know, once I start getting interest in my set, start the raccoons to work this set, because the trail, the raccoon trail, is just right over the camera's backside, right about there. So I'll get them working this set with like fish oils and things like that. Get them down here and get them interested in this set, and then they'll want to put their hand in there and try to get it out. Oh, the bait that I use, that is, which is oysters, mackerel, herring, all kinds of stuff, dog food, cat food, whatever. They can't get all the food out. They might be able to get one or two pieces. They actually got to stick their head in and get their body in here and go all the way back there. And by that time, they've already knocked my promontory peg over and they're caught. So this is a really, really great spot for a body grip trap. Like in Ohio, you're only allowed to put 110s or, you know, like 155s and 160s and stuff like that on land. This is a great spot for something like that. All right, so let's get this trap set up and show you guys what's going on. All right, so let's get this pounded in. And, you know, like I said, this is a great spot for a modern trap, but I just wanted to show you guys this primitive trap, because that's kind of the theme of the series that I got going on right now, is primitive trapping. And of course, once the season starts a little bit more, I'm going to get into more modern trapping with you guys. Alright, let's get these secondary pieces in here. And you're working next to the water's edge, so of course we got a ton of rocks in here. No big deal, just kind of work around it the best we can. Man, there must be a monster rock in there. Same thing on this side. Don't have to look pretty, guys, just gotta be functional. All right, guys, so as you've seen up top of the ridge there, this is basically the bottom part of my trap right here. And what we need to do is we need to set this into the dirt exactly where we want it. And what I want to do is flip it. And I don't think that's going to slide very good, but that will. So that's exactly how I want it when everything's set up. So now I have to make sure that my promontory peg is going to work. And it's a little bit too long, so I need to cut it. No big deal, just trim it up a little bit. See what that gets us. That's pretty much perfect, because once I put tension on this trap, then it's going to be perfect. Right. So the key thing with these promontory pegs is you have to pay attention to direction of travel. And what I want is for this promontory peg to break this way, because his body is going to come in here and he's going to push this promontory peg sideways. So I always want it to break that way. See, if I had it breaking this way, you might be pushing against it a little too much. It still will break, but it's got to basically topple over top of itself. If I put it in this direction, it's braking pretty free and clean. And these things are hair triggers too. As soon as he gets his body in there, pretty much the back of his head and his shoulders bump this promontory peg. It's folding over and this is coming up on him. But if you hear a wood chipper in the background, I guess the guy on the next property over is running a wood chipper. So I apologize for the sound, guys. Now what I got to do is I got to run a line basically in a triangle. This side to this side, and we'll show you that right now. All right, guys, so this is pretty much what we're left with here. So what this is I got a knot on one side and knot on the other. It's a simple, you know, two overhand knots to make a square knot, no big deal. But it comes to a point right here, like a triangle kind of, and that's what I'm gonna attach my spring snare to. And then a promontory peg goes in. All right, guys, so basically the setup is, promontory peg goes in the middle, animal bumps the promontory peg while trying to access the bait. Spring snare goes off, pulls in an upward direction, and it basically is like a body grip trap. Like a primitive conibear, primitive body grip trap, whatever you want to call it. So let's get this set up and attached to our motor up here, our spring device, and show you the end result. All right, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here, pull the trap down to where I want it, set my promontory peg up. And I want that kind of offset to that hole, just like that. So basically what happens is, raccoon or possum, I have caught possum on this before as well, but raccoon, possum, what have you, comes in here and he starts working my set, because I pack things like this, like smoked oysters, a smoked herring, things like that. This is 240 calories just for a little can. There's a can of smoked herring that I keep in my pack that's 780 calories. And it's just really not that much bigger than this either. But what I'll do is I'll open one of these and I'll barely crack it. This is packaged in cottonseed oil. And it stinks, man. I mean, it's got a strong fishy smell. And so I'll barely crack it. And then I'll work some right in front of my set, just like this. You know, just kind of, just a little bit, not much. And then I'll kind of throw some in front, going in that direction, and then I'll get some and I'll splash it up onto the trail. And basically all that does is it gets them down here and gets them working this set all around. Excuse me. And then I'll actually throw some of it into the hole. You know, not when it's set. You don't want to get anywhere near this thing. It'll put a hurting on you. So I'll put some food in the set, and I'll leave just a little tiny bit, I mean like maybe a quarter of an oyster or herring or whatever, right in front. The key to this trap, guys, is you don't ever want to get any oil or fish residue or anything on this promontory peg, because the reason for that is if a raccoon comes down here and starts working your set, and he starts working this promontory peg instead of the trap itself, he's gonna come in here and he's gonna bump this with his nose, or God forbid he starts chewing on it with his teeth. He's just gonna knock it over, and then the trap's gonna go off pretty much right in front of his face. The only thing you're gonna do is scare him to death. So if you got a raccoon or a possum laying anywhere in the vicinity, at least you know you gave him a heart attack. But you gotta have, you know, this pretty much clean. You don't want him working that any at all. And what I like to do is just take some vegetation. We'll get that up here real quick. Just take some longer vegetation and kind of throw in front and back. Just like that. There's that wood chipper, guys. I guess it's those. Ooh, those are nettles. I'm gonna grab them. Now, I'm not going to leave this here because I want to have a good demonstration. But you see what I mean? I'll put a lot of vegetation right in front of the trap, just like this. I want you guys to be able to see. Also, I'll put vegetation on top because I don't want him working the top of this set or anything like that. But, all right, guys. So the main principle of this trap is promontory peg set up. We got the right weight. We got the right weight ratio. We got everything hidden, you know, brushed up. You know, the raccoon can't attack this trap from this side or this side. And we put a little bit of brush in here, so it just makes him not want to come up here. But I want to leave this clean so I have a good demonstration for you guys. All right, guys, I trapped this area a lot. And what I could tell you is 9 times out of 10, the raccoon trail is right up here on the bank. Okay, just right past here. And what happens is the raccoon usually will come down here, start working the tracks, or trap. You can tell by his tracks when I get him trapped, what direction he came from and where he started working the trap from. And he'll get in here, start working the trap, start smelling around, and then he'll notice the more, because I'll put oil in here as well, he'll notice that there's actual goodies in this hole. And he'll get in here with his arm. If that doesn't satisfy him, because I have caught raccoons pretty much by the top of the shoulder blade, and it pins them in there and they can't move. But the really, really good set is when they figure out that they can't get the bait with their hand alone. And that's why I leave this much space, just like that. I leave that much space because they'll figure out, I can't get to it just with my hand. I got to stick my head in there. And they'll actually go to stick their head and their hand and everything in there. And their shoulders and their body will hit this promontory peg and move it over and set the trap. And they're pinned there. I mean, that's a thin stick, and that stick's not coming out very easily at all. And the teeth up here, like I said, guys, just really helps hold that animal up in there really, really well. All right, guys, one thing to consider about a trap like this, this isn't a modern body grip trap or modern Conibear. You know, this isn't going to just quickly kill the animal. You know, so something like this, you only are going to want to use when you need to. You know, when I need to get food. All right, guys, well, this has been William Myers of Mass Outdoors. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please click subscribe below. Liking my video helps me and my channel out a lot. I appreciate all your views, comments, and support, and hopefully we'll see you in the woods. As flat as I can, and the only reason why that is because I'm gonna have travel going on here.
It doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't, and I wanted to like do this.
Yeah. Can you tilt the camera back, please?
Like this.
Back. She said going back.
You said all right. Really.
All right, so.
A big stick. It's not running. The lens cap is all goofy. Hey Myers, Manus Outdoors. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you do, please subscribe. Please subscribe. 3, 2.
Camera.
Yeah. Tomorrow. All right. 3, 2, 1. Alright guys, well, this has been William Myers from Manus Outdoors. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you're enjoying this series on trapping. If you are, please subscribe. I'm doing it.
Wait,
again. I don't know. 3, please click subscribe. Liking my channel helps me and my channel out a lot. Jesus, God Almighty, why can't I spit this out? Welcome to my nightmare. Alright, Myers with Manus Outdoors. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you are, okay, 3, 2, 1. Well, this has been William Myers with Manus Outdoors. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please click scoop cut. Oh my God! I'm gonna have you come over here and do it. 3, 2, 1.